They look good, but how do they sound? Today we're taking a closer look at the new XL8F Reference Series speakers from Fluance Audio. You don't want to miss this. Hi, my name is Frank. Welcome back to channel 33 RPM, your channel for vinyl gear and more. I get a lot of questions from viewers asking for turntable recommendations, but I don't get a lot of questions about speaker recommendations, which is too bad because unless you're using headphones, speakers are, of course, an essential part of the listening experience. That's why I'm so excited to check out these new three-way towers from Fluance. I've had good experiences with Fluance towers in the past, and I'm curious to see how the new ones hold up.
Dear 33ers, remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell. A thumbs up also helps this channel continue to grow. I appreciate your support.
So, Fluance is a Canadian home audio brand. Parent company CWD has a number of other brands, including Electrohome and Magnasonic. Fluance is known for its turntables, as well as its music systems, and of course, its speakers. Fluance has three lines of speakers, the upper end Signature Series, the lower end Elite Series, and the middle of the road Reference Series, which you're taking a look at today. The new XL8F Reference Towers, launched in August of 2020, include a 1-inch slick dome tweeter, 2 6.5-inch mid-range drivers, and 1 8-inch down-firing passive woofer. On the back of these speakers are dual ports and, of course, the binding posts or connectors. For those who want to amplify the bass section separately from the mid-range and tweeter section, the speaker can be biamped. The cabinets are made from MDF, covered in either black ash or natural walnut veneer, with high gloss black fronts and magnetic removable grills. The speakers are hefty, believe me when I tell you that, with each tower weighing nearly 50 pounds and standing almost 4 feet tall. They retail for $599 US or about $800 Canadian a pair, and like all Fluance products, are sold online only. Full disclosure, these speakers are provided to me for review purposes. However, as always, my opinions are my own as well. I gotta tell you, I'm not a professional speaker reviewer by any stretch of the imagination. Rather, I'm a fan of good sounding music and good sounding speakers, so I'm coming at this review from that perspective. Of course, I also have some previous experience with Fluance speakers. I recently purchased a Fluance center channel and subwoofer for my home theater, and I really dig them both. I also have a pair of Fluance towers I bought 5 or 6 years ago. Those were the XL7F model. The XL8Fs we're checking out today are an updated version of that speaker. So let's take a closer look. I first tried out these speakers using the stereo I have right there behind me, which consists of a Marantz PM6004 integrated amp, a Marantz CD 6004 CD player, and a Technics SL1200 Mark II turntable. I connected the speakers using speaker wire I got from Monoprice, and to connect the speakers, I used banana plugs. If you don't have banana plugs, buy them. Trust me, they make your life easier. For testing purposes, I used my usual test albums. Those are David Bowie's Let's Dance, because that album is just produced so well. I also used Kiss, Dressed to Kill, mostly for the simplicity of the production, and I also used Pink Floyd Division Bell, which gives any decent music system a serious workout. When you get new speakers, the first thing you want to do is break them in. It really does make a difference. Fluance recommends 10 hours or so at regular listening volume. I noticed that after about 7 or 8 hours, these speakers really started to open up, but after 20 hours, they sounded even better. The first thing I noticed after breaking the speakers in was a tight, punchy bass response. It hits you in the gut when listening at a good volume. Crank the middle part of Bowie's Let's Dance, preferably on vinyl, and you'll know what I mean. You can thank the down-firing woofer for that. It's passive, but man, this thing has bite. As for the highs, they were smooth and clear, not harsh, so I have no complaints there. The tweeters, by the way, are the same ones used in the more expensive Signature series. Now, initially, the mids did not blow me away. However, they really started to open up over time. I also noted that while the soundstage is pleasant, I wasn't quite getting that giant, that huge three-dimensional quality from them. That said, I'm gonna play with the speaker placement a bit more to see if I can improve on that. In terms of looks, these things are gorgeous and look much more expensive than they actually are. Remember, these towers retail for $599 US for the pair, for both of them. The fronts of the speakers are clean and sleek. There is no sign of mounting hardware, screws and such, and that looks great. Fit and finish are also nice, and I really dig the look of the woven drivers. Also, I swear that these speakers sound better with the front grills off, but that could be my imagination. I did several listening tests comparing the new XL8F speakers to the old XL7Fs. Physically, the new speakers and the old speakers look similar. The speaker placement has changed slightly, as have the size of the grills and the Fluance emblem. At the back, the binding posts have also been updated. But there have been more significant changes under the hood. According to Fluance, while the two speakers, the old version and the new version, follow the same general form factor, the XL8Fs feature improved components, including the woven drivers, which I gotta say, do look pretty cool. The company says the new drivers are lighter and more rigid, resulting in less distortion. Fluance has also redesigned the crossover and cabinet. All this has resulted in greater frequency response. Now, if you were to ask me, I think the new version not only looks better, but it sounds more wide open, again with that punchier, tighter bass response. The mids, I thought, were a little more pronounced in the older version, but again, that could be due to the fact that the drivers in these speakers are not fully broken in yet. Fluance's new XL8F reference tower speakers have the power to fill a room and to punch you in the gut if you let them. They're well constructed, fit and finish is nice, and they look fantastic. While they do lack the refinement of some more costly towers, particularly in the mids and maybe the soundstage, it's not something I would dwell on too much, particularly at this price point. The XL8F reference tower speakers provide exceptional value for your money, and they are right at home in a two-channel setup or in a home theater. Bottom line, these speakers offer excellent performance and good looks at a reasonable cost, and to me, that's a winning formula. All right, 33ers, have you tried out Fluance speakers? What do you think of them? What speakers are you rocking in your home setup? I'd love to know. Let us know in the comments below. For those interested, I will leave a link to the Fluance website below this video. Speaking of this video, if you dug it, I'd appreciate a quick thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, what the heck are you waiting for? Dear 33ers, I hope each and every one of you has a fantastic week. Until next time, keep on spinning.